Hey, I'm Alex Radical from Board Game Co., and today I'm unboxing Into Deep by Burnt Island Games. And if you're wondering why we have these over here, honestly, two reasons. One is it looks better in the thumbnail, just fills up the shot nicely, adds a little more color, a little more whatever. They also look pretty just lined up like that. And two is because this is an unboxing and rambling, and generally when I do an unboxing and rambling, it just means I'm talking about stuff and things. I usually walk in with at least one thing that I want to talk about, and then from there the conversation will go wherever it will go. And that one thing is that this weekend I actually had the opportunity to spend some time with Burnt Island Games, and we'll talk about that shortly, and when I do, it'll become a little more clear what's going on here. Also, cursed me to tell you, in case you don't know, Burnt Island Games and KTBG, Kids Table Board Games, which is the company behind these three, same company, just different lines of games. One for more gamer-focused gamers, and the other for, well, more of a kids line, although don't let the word kids line deceive you. We'll talk about that. But it's very kid-friendly while being adult-friendly. That's really what it's doing. I'm getting sidetracked. Coffee shot, in case you're wondering. Speaking of which, by the way, I chose this mug specifically because this is going to be the Family Gamers. They have a podcast. I'll link to that down below. But it says over here on the cup, play games with your kids. And I figured once I'm talking about this, which is only because I'm talking about this, which was loosely connected to the company, then I'll also include that mug. Honestly, this whole thing has gone completely sideways. It is what it is. Let's go ahead and unbox Into Deep. Into Deep is going to be the fantastic game designed by Josh Capel and Daryl Cho. And this is... this was, oh my gosh. Okay, so let's talk about things. Burnt Island Games has a few games under their belt. They have their first game, I want to say their first game, was going to be Endeavor. They did Endeavor, Age of Sail, along with the Grand Gamers Guild. They did that campaign together. Endeavor is a reprint of the game Endeavor, and they did a reprint campaign where they reprinted it, deluxified it, made it look all pretty, added some modules, some expansions, and then brought that to Kickstarter. They then brought an expansion to Kickstarter as well, an expansion to Endeavor Age of Sail. I don't know, I'm closing the knife, I'll probably still need it. And then from there they brought, well, the expansion technically came after, they brought In the Hall of the Mountain King, then they brought the expansion, then they brought Fall of the Mountain King. I think I'm doing this in the right order. I think Fall of the Mountain King was next, that was a recent one. I gave that one a 5 out of 5, really enjoyed it. Generally their games have been 4s out of 4, 4 to 5s for me, which is still a solid rating. They've all lacked that something to push it over 5. Fall of Mountain King, though, really, really enjoyed that one. I enjoyed all the games, to be clear. Well, most, all the games in the KTBG line, most of the, no, all their games from the Burnt Island Games line, and most of the games from the KTBG line. So, what do we have here? We have Into Deep, the Crackdown mini expansion. And we'll talk about Into Deep shortly. It was a Kickstarter that I covered. I covered it, well, a while ago when it was on Kickstarter. This is the most eloquent I've ever been. We have the rulebook over here. The rulebook, which is this, if you've ever seen a rulebook illustrated by Josh Capel, in addition to being a designer, a graphic designer, a developer, he has some of the clearest and easiest to comprehend rulebooks that I've seen. His stuff is absolutely insane. The formatting, the structure, the iconography, the clear breakdowns. His rulebooks, whether being done for KTBG, for Burnt Island Games, or for a variety of other companies, are insane. There are some games that you may not, if you ever played Wasabi from Z-Man Games, he did that. He does a lot of work with Grand Gamers Guild. He's done a lot of work with TMG before they went under. He did Belfort. He did Scoville. He did a bunch of other games. He did Mercury Games. He did the Walled City, Londonbury. Lots of stuff. Lots and lots of games. But either way, I'm getting sidetracked, which has been pretty clear because I've been sidetracked since the very beginning of this video. But that's going to be your rulebook. Let's just cover that one thing that I always forget to do. The rulebook is going to be 18 pages, 19 pages long, one page of solo rules, and if you start from the actual, you know, actual game and skip setup, you're talking about pages 7 all the way to 18. Pages 7 to 18, that's only 11 pages of rules, very easy to get through. If you don't already know, Into Deep, and why would you know? Unless, of course, you watched previous content, in which case, then you know.
Now, this is going to be the deluxe version of the game. This is going to be the deluxe version that was on Kickstarter. It comes with a bunch of extras, such as the miniatures, upgraded tokens. I think there are little Sentinel tokens that we'll get to shortly. A bunch of upgrades and additions, some gameplay content, some extras like that that you got in the deluxe version of the game. Alternatively, if you backed it on retail, you got most of the same stuff, just, well, You got standees instead of miniatures. These miniatures here, so you got standees instead of all of those. If I recall correctly, you may have gotten fewer characters, or I don't remember exactly. There was also some additional expansion content as well. Some upgraded tokens. I'm trying to remember what else there was. There was a Sentinel. Were there upgraded tokens? I don't remember exactly. I know that there were those additional standee trays that were utilized instead. But let's go ahead and take everything out over here, and let's just start going into all of it. Let's toss this to the side, and let's go ahead and open all of this up. So, yep, that's okay. 1 second, and let's just put this off to the side, and we'll go ahead and get this opened up. So this is going to be all the content. Let's start going through all of this over here, the tokens, the trays, the boards, all that stuff.
Now, Into Deep is going to be a game. Let's go ahead and just set it up generally. So we're going to go ahead and put this over here. It's going to be a game where you're going to set up in a little district of a city with these various locations and just pop them around and then create a little district. And it's a game where you're managing a puzzle. That's what you're doing here. All you're doing is you're managing a puzzle of trying to get different things in locations with other things. It's a fascinating little puzzle where you have these cards you're trying to achieve, and the cards will get escalating in their levels of difficulty. Let's try to put this center camera as much as it can go. You're going to have these various, well, the miniatures, which we haven't talked about yet, but we absolutely should because they're miniatures. But you're going to have, ooh, these are fun. Nice. These are solid little chunky hefty miniatures. In fact, I don't know, did they do miniatures before? They did. I mean, Endeavor Age of Sail had miniature-esque things, but not really miniatures. Let's go ahead and dump him onto one of these bases. So you're going to have these different characters that are going to be wandering around the map, and you have these goals to basically move characters to different zones. So let's go ahead and put this in. Let's kind of clip that in there. Let's push that a little bit further. Okay. And then, there we go. Okay, so we're going to get him, and you might have an objective saying, get this guy in the zone with the thing. Where's the thing? We got to find the thing now. These are going to be some sideboards, which we'll talk about shortly. They're falling apart. Then we have various tokens. Let's see. Here we go. Here are going to be some of the tokens you'll have. So you might want to have the car. So you might want to be able to move this guy into the parish with the car. So he's going to wander here. He's going to pick it up. He's going to move it over there. And then you will reveal a card showing you fulfilled a goal. And we have is you have a limited number of actions every round. And you're trying to set up, by the way, punch boards. You're trying to set up these combinations of, well, I'm going to move here, get this done. I'm also going to, like, you know, use these special ability tokens because you can earn special ability tokens. I'm going to use those to be able to further get my goals because those first abilities are pretty easy. The abilities get harder and harder and harder as you go through the game. But why is it called Into Deep, you ask? A great question. It's called Into Deep because of this aspect of corruption that you have in the game, where as you accomplish different things or take different cards, you run the risk of getting further and further corrupt. You're an agent who's trying to conspire against the deep state that is, doing stuff and stuff and stuff. And so, as you continue to get things done, or as you continue to gather cards, you're increasing your scoring, but you're also running the risk of going in too deep. And if you do go in too deep, you get like a 30-point hit to your score, if I recall correctly. And that can be the difference between winning and losing. And in fact, it has been the difference between winning and losing in some games. Now here's going to be the Mech Sentinel. This guy's delightful over here. Here we go. So let's go ahead and show you this guy. That's going to be the little mech. He's one of the characters that will go on the board and has to be manipulated around the board. You can see him over here. Sentinel, when you move a character over here, you can go ahead and move this guy here, and then you can activate the location you're in, and that would move the Sentinel 1, 2, 3, and he can often pick things up and move them with him. Again, I'm going mostly by memory on the rules here, so if I get anything's a little bit wrong, remember this is an unboxing video, barely an unboxing, it's an unboxing and rambling, which means this is more just about generalities. So, we have these over here, we have these stuff, we have the miniatures, and we have these little Sentinel tokens. So here's the way these work, okay? These are delightful. These are one of my favorite updates when they announced them on the Kickstarter. But basically, what you're going to do is you're going to start the game off by having these little drones over here in different zones. And you have this aspect of attracting heat to different zones. So for example, if you go ahead and you now activated this zone over here, which sends that Sentinel robot over there, you shift a little bit of heat to the different zones. So you grab one robot from each zone, move over to that zone, and now you can't activate this zone, but you can now activate this zone. And then when you move here, you're going to again move 1, 1, and 1, and you can see how it effectively creates this countdown timer that each time you activate a new zone, it attracts heat to that zone, and then slowly opens up the other zones that you can use their ability again. It works really well, and these little robot miniatures are absolutely delightful. These little Sentinel drones, let's see if we can show you one over here. I don't know if the camera will focus something this small. We'll see. It looks like it will, or ish, mostly. Anyways, that's going to be the aspect of heat and all that. We have these bases for the various miniatures that they clip into nicely. And again, they have these nice little card trays. Now, one of the nice things about these bases and the reason you have these is because of those token spots. Let's see if we can grab our token trays back that we already put away, confidently thinking that we would be done. And let's go ahead and grab one of the tokens, which I actually had. I had one right over here. I don't know why I needed to do that. We have these tokens over here, which they slot nicely into these bases, which makes your life a whole lot easier to have that over there, so you can wander around the board carrying your various tokens, because each character can carry one thing at a time. You move around, you go to the spot you need, you know, you move with this character to there with the blue thing in the downtown, and then have the sentinel directly across from it. Boom, there you go. And you set these combos up. We have these chains, these cards. Where's my knife? I need my knife. I assume these are the cards that give you the abilities. And then we go over here. Oh my gosh, this game's been so long since I played it. This is when we were doing a lot of TTS plays for prototypes. And I played it in person as well, but I got my first few plays on TTS, and then I played it in person, and we have, oh my gosh, these cards. Okay, so we have the level 1, level 2, and level 3 cards. Let's see if we can find them. And then we have general cards as well. So level 1, level 2, level 3. Let's see if we can show you a 3, a 2, and a 1, just to give you an idea of how different they are. And then you have these general abilities over here that will give you just extras for accomplishing them each turn. They tend to be easier. They're not meant to be the ongoing effects. And they have solid little player aids as well. Again, a Josh Capel style player aid, showing you everything you need, beautifully illustrated, the character on the other side, all that stuff there. So let's go through a general idea of how this works. Now, fly on the wall. You must be in downtown holding the bird's eye. So you have to be downtown holding the bird's eye. This is the car we need to be. That's that simple. There we go. Just be here holding the bird's eye, plain and simple. You reveal this card at the end of your turn, and you get one of these two awards, which are going to be some form of points, some form of extra award tokens, and then as well some cards that will be, well, helpful. You want to try to get sets of cards that will give you a whole bunch of points. That's going to be that card there. Plain and simple. Let's go to card number 2. The gun droid must be loose in Zanzibar. You must be exactly 2 zones away with no blockades between. You can see how this starts to escalate. So we have these blockades over here. I think these are the blockade tokens. And you must have the gun droid. That's going to be that little yellow token. Must be loose in Zanzibar. So it's not being Zanzibar. So it's Zinbazar. Zinbazar. So it's not being held. So it has to be over here. You have to have a token here. It's not being held by anyone. And you must be exactly 2 zones away with no blockades between, which means this wouldn't count, but this one would. So again, it's getting more specific. Now, if you're thinking, okay, that's still achievable, you're right. But when we get to level 3, a criminal holding the gun droid, so now someone else has to be holding the gun droid, must be in the skyport. You must be exactly 3 zones away holding the coupe. There must be 3 blockades between you. So again, it starts getting escalating more difficult. And these cards, you tend to either need to hope things don't change round to round across multiple rounds, or alternatively, you need to just basically use a whole bunch of powers and abilities. Now, one of the things that's nice with the game, if I can show you here on the, do we have the player boards? Player boards somewhere. Are there player boards? Oh, here we go. Player boards are being covered by this. So the player boards have this aspect that you can basically start locking up every time you get grip into these characters, because you're not actually these characters. You're gripping into them. You're like remote hacking or whatever you want to call it into these characters. And as you slowly move up these tracks, you can earn extra actions. The combination of cashing in on your extra actions, as well as, well, you know, utilizing special ability tokens you've earned throughout the game, that's ultimately how you, well, get these level 3 abilities. That or patience and a hefty degree of luck. That's going to be basically that. I'm going to start putting these away as I go through it. That one goes there. Nope, that one goes there. That one goes there. And let's show you all these characters, and then let's just ramble on a bit more. So we have all the various characters in the game, each with their own special ability of the abilities you can activate when you take their turn with them. That one goes there. We have this character over here. I don't know any of the characters' names, to be very, very clear. But that's going to be that. Then we have, I feel like I'm missing a character. Nope, that's going to be this one here. Then we have this little squid-faced dude. Really just a mask, if you think about it. But yeah, all that. And then we have the cowboy dude. All the names are like the squid-faced dude, the cowboy dude. Probably have a gal in there somewhere. There we go. And we have the racing gal. You see, I knew we can get a gal in there. The racing gal. That's going to be this one over here. Oh, focus, focus. There we go. Look at her. Look at her go. She's racing to get the job done. Then we got another 2 over here, and then we call that a wrap. We both of them gals. We got the twisting dancing gal. Okay, you see, that's over here. Yep, there we go. And then we got the, that one's like, she really looks like she's like trying to get out. And we got the stealth gal, who's one of my favorites actually. rogue, ghost, I don't know. But either way, she looks like she can get the job done. So, while I clean this up, let's go ahead. And that's basically just this. I just wanted to show it to you because it's cool. And let's see if I can get this to go back where it's supposed to go. Go back. It's like not going the way it's supposed to go there. Okay, we'll figure it out later. Anyways, why won't it go? No, this is going to bother me now. Go into the box the way you're supposed to. I feel it's like kind of semi on an angle there. Let's put these robots away. So basically, I was recently in Toronto, which is where I grabbed this. I grabbed this from Burnt Island Games directly. They were, you know, I dropped by their studio to basically play some games and talk because we have a few games that we need to talk about here. We have Fossilisus, Recreators, and Power Plants. Now, the only reason Fossilisus is here is because, well, I once I had two of them, I wanted to have the full set of three. It's not really the full set, but I wanted to have the set of three. There's also Creature Comforts, which we haven't talked about as well. That's going to be a Kickstarter. But either way, so we had, basically, Fossilisus is going to be one of the games. I've played Fossilisus, but I have to play it again before I have a review of it. I've played it a few more times, but more specifically, my problem with Fossilisus, and it's not really a problem, is that I played it with my kids, and I think it might have been a little too advanced. I played it with all the rules. They have KTBG, one of the things they actually do really well, is they give you partial rules that you can play with children. So if you want to get like a feel for the game, you can play X, Y, and Z with this rule and that rule. But I thought my kids would be up for it, so I played the full Fossilisus with them, and it was a bit too much for some of my younger children, which also ruined the experience a bit for me. They focused primarily on just digging things out from, you know, the fossils, and they focused less on the gameplay, which wasn't a bad experience. I enjoyed myself, but I did walk away from it a little bit less, you know, in a rush to, like, play that game again, because it was fine, but it was a little marred by not being what I thought it would be, I guess, if that makes sense. It's just, it was not light enough to be fun for them, and it was heavier, but they weren't really playing it to a heavier tune. But point is, I need to play Fossilisus again with my older kids, like just Ricky and maybe some other people, some adults. Again, the game's adult-friendly. They're KTBG games. They're very adult-friendly. They're very kid-friendly as well if you remove certain rules from the game. They usually tell you, like, remove this, remove that, and they can slowly work your way up. I just foolishly didn't listen because I thought my kids would be fine. But anyways, that's going to be Fossilisus. So need more plays of it. Overall enjoyed it, but need to really get a better feel for it. Give me a second. Coffee break. The weirdest part about these coffee unboxings, I have the coffee, but I rarely actually drink as much coffee as I'd like doing the unboxing itself. This won't fit here. We'll have to figure that out. Anyway, so that's going to be Fossilisus. Then Power Plants and Recreators, I actually played while I was in Toronto. While I was visiting their studio, I played, I picked up Into Deep, but I played Power Plants and Recreators. Power Plants is going to be an upcoming Kickstarter. That's going to be October 26th, I want to say. It's going to be coming to Kickstarter, and it's going to be giving you, how do these fit in here? These, like, kind of, there we go. So, they're going to be coming to Kickstarter. It's going to be area control for kids, is the way I would put it. It's giving you good, you know, core area control, what's the word? There's a word I'm missing here. The building blocks. It's the building blocks of area control. That's the word I'm looking for. So in case you want your kids to be playing area control games for, or why not want your kids? In case your kids want to be playing area control games, in case you want to introduce different mechanics to your children, just to see if they like them, well, Power Plants does that excellently in terms of giving you quick and simple area control, plays in about half an hour, and ultimately is all about basically creating these little, and this is prototype over here, I'm not going to show it right now, I will be covering this on the channel, but it's giving you these little patches of plants you're building up and trying to get your sprites onto, and every time you place a plant down, you either take the plant's ability or all the abilities of the ones around it, but the weaker abilities. We'll get into it more, but effectively it's fast, it's fast-paced area control that it plays 2 to 5. We'll talk about it more. I think 5 is a little crowded. I think 3 and 4 is going to be the sweet spot of the game, but we'll talk about that more. But overall, played that with them in Toronto. And then I also played Recreators, and Recreators is delightful. This rivals Comfort Creatures for me as far as one of my favorite KTBG games so far. I played a bunch of them. I don't have them all in this video. But for me, KTBG, and again, Fossilisus is still pending my opinion. We'll have to get more of a plays in. But I would say Recreators and Comfort Creatures are my favorite so far, with currently Fossilisus and Power Plants coming right behind it in terms of how much I like them, although more plays are needed of both of those. But yeah, Recreators is absolutely delightful. I'll have a review coming in at some point, but this is one I've already gotten a bunch of plays in, and it's surprising. I mean, I'm just like blown away at how good this game is and how I haven't played it yet. It's a lot of fun, great for adults, great for kids, lots of pathways to victories, designed by Josh Capel again, a solid game. We'll talk about it another time. I just have this on the table because, like I said already, I played a bunch of their games while I was there and figured I'll throw KTBG onto this, even though this video is probably just called Into Deep Unboxing or something like that. Anyways, that's going to be basically it. I'm just going to go finish my coffee over there and clean up the mess behind me on the floor. But until next time, I'm Alex Radcliffe from Board Game Co. And as always, have a good one.